What's up? We are back again this Wednesday with another video, which is kind of different.
Yeah, it's very different. I don't think we've ever done any confessional stuff.
But there's a reason for that, because we've never been married before. So we're talking about confessions or revelations or new things that we've
discoveries.
Learned. Discoveries about each other after having been married for 4 months.
Yep. You go first.
Why do I go first?
Yes, because I want to know what your discovery is.
Okay, so discovery number one is Sherry is not a morning person. She's anyways.
But you've always known that.
Yeah, I mean, I've known that you wake up late every morning. But what I've discovered is that when you wake up, you're not very nice.
Yeah, I like my space. Like, I don't like.
Yeah, you're putting it a little too politely. I think she's grumpy.
But I like my space. Like, I like my laptop, my tea, and my little like area, and nobody in
and
that
nobody
area.
Nobody in that area.
Yeah.
So yeah, I've had a few close calls in the morning.
Okay. I'm actually gonna say something positive about you in the morning. That you're like the best wake up call ever.
What does that mean?
Means Vaibhav is really affectionate in the morning, and it's like he wakes up much before me.
Yeah.
And then slowly, when it's like my time to wake up, he comes and he's
which
like
is almost noon.
Showers me with like cuddles and kisses, and is like, it's not almost noon. Did you say noon? That's rubbish. I wake up at 9 a.m.
He just realized.
Like, and yeah, and it's really sweet. Like, earlier I used to experience it maybe once a week. Now it's every day, so yeah.
Confession number two is that after we've gotten married, I really enjoy sitting at the table and eating as a family. So earlier it used to be like I would sit in my room and watch TV while eating. Mum would be in her room, you know, eating on her own. But after we got married, we have been eating like a family. You know how we set the table, which was a concept that Sherry completely introduced. We set the table and then we just all sit down together and eat. I'm really into it.
So the one thing I feel like that both of us have struggled with, and Vaibhav is still struggling with, is calling each other's parents mom and dad.
Yeah.
It's like overnight you're supposed to be like,
yeah, you have new mommies and new daddies.
Hello, new mommy, daddy. And yeah, initially it's really awkward, and I have kind of gotten around to it now, but
but you live with my mom, so obviously we...
Yeah, like it's really weird, but like I think it took us a few weeks, like we didn't start
also,
off with
and
like
also the fact,
and
also
like,
the fact that we've been together,
from
like, I don't know.
Yeah, and we're so used to saying auntie,
yeah,
auntie, uncle,
yeah.
Auntie,
so
uncle,
it's,
like
it slips out.
Yeah, I think initially when I remember when we had just gotten married, like a few weeks later, and I was talking to my mom on the phone, and I said auntie, and I was with someone, and they were like, you call your mother your auntie? And I was like, I've always called her auntie. And I'm like, it's a little odd. I'm getting into it.
Because like over 12 years of calling someone auntie or uncle, and you can't just flip.
Vaibhav still hasn't flipped.
I mean, I try, but it just slips out. Okay, so discovery number three for me is actually related to what you just said. I've discovered that I'm a bit of a cuddler.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not ashamed to admit it.
Vaibhav loves to cuddle.
I'm a bit of a cuddler.
This is us every night.
And I'm actually more of a cuddler than you are.
Yeah,
she used to be a cuddler before we got married, and I think now I'm overdoing it, so she's like back off.
Vaibhav is always cuddling. He's like, you're actually sitting like a cuddler right now as well. See,
this is not a cuddle, hello. I'm sitting like a latsa.
Okay. A laksa who cuddles.
A little bit.
So I've always known that Vaibhav doesn't have a lot of stuff, but it's just become really apparent now that we live together. Like, your closet is like...
Are you calling me poor?
Two shelves. And there's like, he's always wearing the same clothes. It's just ridiculous how he wears the same t-shirt every few days.
Same shorts,
and it's like almost like I've become his personal stylist, where he wears the same thing and then says, oh, is it cool, and I'm like, it was cool 3 days ago.
But I'm rich when it comes to sneakers.
It's not like you don't have clothes. You do have clothes, but you just wear the same thing over and over again.
No, but they get old, right? Then you gotta like...
Means he has to like use them like ragda the new t-shirt. Like this is a new one. Now just wait and watch. You're gonna wear this.
No, I've already worn this like 6-7 times.
And now it's gonna be the new favorite because it'll be on top of the pile. And then
then it goes into the sleeping clothes pile.
After like... aggressive usage.
After, like, it's dead. Okay, so a serious discovery that I've made is that marriage. What is marriage?
Ooh, it's all getting all like deep.
What does it feel like to be married? Well, it feels like you're in an emotional gym.
What does that mean? I think you're gonna say an emotional roller coaster. What is an emotional gym?
I mean, it's another way of saying that you have to work your emotional muscles. Like one moment you're happy and you're dancing around. And the next moment it's like...
Or like...
Yeah, or you're at each other's throats and...
Yeah, it's actually really... What I find the strangest is normally when we used to fight over the phone. So I could like... You hang up and you...
I used to be the one who used to hang up mostly.
Okay. There's no pride in that.
I'm just saying.
And now when you fight with the person, you have to face them. Like you can't really just...
You have to live with them.
Yeah, you can't just be like...
They are in your bed, in your face, in your kitchen, in your room.
Our bed, our kitchen, our room.
So you gotta work things out. And that feels like a workout, an emotional workout, hence an emotional gym. See, I come in from here and then I go...
Vaibhav, I'm just gonna come out and say this, you make me less messy. Like, I'm a bit of a mess maker, don't exaggerate. But he is like a stickler in our bedroom, like I can't even have a bag lying like here. He'll be like, babe, what is that bag doing here? Babe, can you put your stuff away?
So what I do is I basically stop her before it gets out of hand. So when I see a bag lying on the floor and it hasn't moved in like 4 hours, I know that it's going to multiply. There will be 2 bags the next day and 4 the next and like 5 the next.
So you like nip it in the bag?
Yes, so I don't let it get out of hand because it gets out of hand. It really does. With Cherry.
You're like the little monitor.
Yeah,
I'm a mess monitor. So just last night he was like, babe, I think your dressing table is getting a little messy. Like those things over there and you know the stuff on the bottom.
Yeah, so it was just a warning.
Yeah, and he said, I'm being really nice. I'm just warning you.
Bringing it to your notice.
Yeah, bringing it to your notice. Yeah. It's still there.
Because if I had said the word warning you,
yeah,
then you know my workout will start. Emotional workout. Okay, so the last discovery is a bit of a random one, but Sherry doesn't like to use the wiper in the loo after she's had.
So you want to explain what a wiper is? Because a lot of people don't know what a wiper is and they've never used one like me before.
What?
We don't have a wiper in our house. You wipe
the floor after you've had a bath.
Long thing that goes.
Yeah, I think normal people do that.
No.
Yeah, well, that's why maybe you don't like it. No. So she hates that. Hates doing that. So it's always like, oh no, I'm gonna go for a bath before you.
Yeah.
So that then you go for a bath and you have to wipe.
Because we both have a bath at night, and I hate doing it at night. Like it's like in the night you like had a long day.
I have
day.
A bath in the morning also.
And then yes, but we also have a bath at night. And then that's the worst one. The morning you're still like, okay, I can wipe. In the night you're like after
you're,
a bath.
You're never like this with the wiper. You're always like,
oh. Oh, I just wait for Weber to go to sleep and then go for a bath and then you wipe.
Yeah, and then I wake up. In the middle of the night, go to the loo.
It's a paddle.
It's like I'm in a pond.
Okay, last one. Vaibhav is the real salt bae.
Is it real?
Salt bae.
Oh, salt bae.
Means at least 4 or 5 times in a week, he's like, oh, there's too much salt in the food. Oh, there's too little salt in the food. Oh, there's too much salt in the food. There's no salt in the food. I don't know how he figures it out, but like, I never can tell.
See, us... food connoisseurs,
yeah.
We have
salt, you know, obsessors is more
no,
like
we have a very refined palate.
Yeah, sure.
So it's offensive to eat too much salt and then it's, you know,
equally
nice.
Offensive to eat less.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah. So, you know,
it's really like alternate days. Like one day he's like, it's too much salt today. next day he's like, there's no salt.
But obviously you don't take it personally.
Yeah, because I don't make it, but see, it's like every meal, salt free.
Alright, so those were the confessions slash discoveries that we have made in the last 4 months of being married.
And there will be plenty more.
So there will be more videos.
Yes.
And
if you enjoyed it, thumbs up.
And we shall see you next Wednesday. Bye.
Bye.